I'm Ravi here. So I'm a bachelor's in engineering and a master's in international business, having around 13 years of experience in SAP and having more than 20 implementations and around 11 support and various projects in upgrade rollout as a project manager. And I'm a PMP certified and a master's certified in SAP with sales and distribution, CRM and IS utilities. And as far as the project management is concerned, I have dealt with more than 11 modules. So before we go ahead with our discussion, can I know something brief about you guys?
Hello?
Yeah, Anand.
Hi, Ravi.
Yeah.
I have 10 years of experience in SAP.
Okay.
And I have 7 plus years in SAP ECC technical.
Okay.
And 3 years in SAP CRM.
Okay.
But not in depth. I mean, I got an opportunity while I'm working as an SAP technical consultant.
Okay.
Work in CRM.
Okay.
So I touched a couple of areas in CRM. Not
good. Okay. Okay. So something in the area of related with Web and Pro or workflow or something, middleware.
Right. Oh. I have worked on all modules in ECC,
mm-hmm.
The core ECC.
Okay.
And also I worked on Web and Pro and workflows as well.
Okay. That sounds good. So how about Santosh? Santosh has a similar kind of.
No, not exactly. But I'm 12 years experience. But I have I work on a little bit CRM marketing,
mm-hmm.
but it's not like a ERP package. It's like a in-house built-in applications kind of stuff. So.
Oh, okay. That's good.
I want to get SAP CRM. So.
Okay. So you both have some part of interaction with the CRM packages. That's good. Because each individual again understands the subject in a different way. So my entire training goes with an ideas based model. So because ideas is a model enterprise within the SAP package. But yes, we would be discussing about almost every customization aspect which is required for the work oriented activity. Let me log into my SAP. So you're on my screen, right? Both of you. So I hope you are already aware, or let me update you about a fundamental CRM. Again, CRM was a subset of ERP way back around 8 years back. So much deals with marketing, sales and service modules, and its backend is purely logistics, something like your sales and distribution, materials management, your FSEO or your warehouse management, because any industry or any company or any retail company or any online company which requires to work with lot of virtual business, something like without setting up their own offices, they can do a business maybe 100 times better than what regularly they're doing with a physical, because these days most of the businesses are going inorganic way of developing their business. Companies want to develop their cars business in another country with less number of showrooms. Companies want to sell their laptops across the globe without having a proper presence in that country. So if you want to grow your businesses virtually, so into the e-commerce, into the telecommerce, into the mobile commerce, then CRM is a must and should implementation where every company is these days looking to upgrade themselves into CRM. From a small, medium to large enterprises, you name it, they are going into CRM. And SAP CRM being one of the oldest and ERP related CRM. So this is the only 100% ERP integrated CRM available in the market. So that is the reason SAP CRM is doing far better than other ERPs or CRMs, because of the inclination towards it is having a proprietary ERP. The day he has designed this CRM, he had it in mind that let me design a CRM which is integrated with the backend. So this is an interface which I'm showing you. So let me show you the architecture of CRM. From there I'll start my discussion on any given day. So this is the CRM system architecture. So where we have to understand that there are three layers, and when the SAP CRM has been introduced, the first and foremost thing is because of the middleware, it has become more famous than the Siebel's or Salesforce's, other kinds of small and medium CRMs. This is a large scale company CRM, though small companies can also use it. But yes, large companies like eBay, like Walmart, like Microsoft, Google, these kind of companies cannot use. Even there are companies, IBM is having their own CRM, but to run their business they had to implement SAP CRM. IBM doesn't run on like SAP Labs itself runs on SAP CRM. Entire SAP's business is driven by 5000 plus team of CRM in Germany, US and India together. So they work out the SAP customers, they take the complaints, they market the product, they do sales. So SAP is a proper example in the world to be successful in the CRM business, because they themselves are using this package. That is how it stands to be standout CRM. So this middleware, where you're seeing, where I'm talking about mobile integration, you remotely use any application, I'm ready to take your data. I'm ready to give you data. And these dotted lines are nothing but RFC connections. And basis is the low-end architecture where the database and the basis framework which we do have. And the top end comes with business objects and application components, where we do not add more objects and more components. We only reuse them in SAP. SAP has a biggest reusability package within the installation. So these business objects and these components are coming as a standard. Components generally refer to modules, objects refer to your master data and transaction data related application and screens. So basically when you come about this thing, talk about this architecture, so you have this is called SAP Easy Access. The second one is IMG, where we go to SPRO, where we have to customize reference IMG. And the third part, So the third part, like which we do have something called as business roles, like which SAP has come up with CRM 6.0 onwards. Right now we are running on CRM 7.1 EHP 1. So this is the version which is going on. And if you can see, and this EHP 2, right, very recently, 1 month back, it is released, and it is more of a HANA driven CRM. So HANA is one of the latest optimized memory computing platform which SAP has come up with. But anyway, so coming to business roles, because SAP CRM uses a lot of individual roles, like something as e-commerce manager who is a web channel manager, you can see IC agent, you can see IT service professional, you can see marketing professional. So there are a lot of people who will be involved in the business. So SAP has designed these screens for them. So whenever we get into this web UI functionality, this runs on a server called web application server and NetWeaver platform, which is for integration, and the third one which it really uses is all the web services which are available in today's market, like service oriented architecture, enterprise service oriented architecture, ESOA. All these things are integrated within this web UI, and there is something called BSP workbench. That's called, it's taking a little time, just a minute. So BSP workbench is something which is used by CRM technical staff. So just a minute. So our configurations are mainly based on SPRO because we are much into functional. And coming to the technical stuff, like we would be analyzing this easy enhancement workbench and also the BSP components. So BSP architecture stands out differently, which works on a BSP work process. And and how far you guys are having some idea on the functional part, like something like marketing, sales and service?
I have a little idea on the marketing, but not on the sales and
on
service.
The sales.
I know a little bit about contact centers and all the stuff.
Okay.
But not on the complete details.
Yeah. How about you, Anand?
Zero. I don't know any functional thing about sales.
So it's a pretty easy thing because I would be, because once we start our sessions, we would be sharing some.
Welcome to SAP Sales Distribution and CRM Learners. So this is my website and my channel www.youtube.com/users/RaviataMP. And you can visit my website for all the details of certification, training, on-job support with a dedicated service tool and having our own CRM. So you can watch my website for all the details and also the training materials which I'm uploading frequently on daily basis. So try to work out on some of those examples, like which I'll be coding, and also some interview questions. You can also approach me for my for resume preparation, support, post offer in a company, or before getting an offer, if you're stuck in some of the project training aspects, you can come down. And I also have my contents, like which are noted down here. And for corporates, like we have a specific package, like companies in US who want their OPTs or CPTs or experts get into SAP industry. Not only SAP CRM and SD, even the non CRM and non-SD guys, with my experience of around 14 years in SAP industry, I would be helping the candidates to get hold of the first offer in the market. So you can also approach me for the certification guidance, where I can ensure you the 100% certification. Though you are being directly writing exams with SAP America, India or other companies, so with my experience of certification, I can give you some standard questionnaires which would stand as a practice for your questions to clear your interviews. You can also join me on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn and YouTube, Skype, Google Plus, Hangout. So this is what about my few things about my website, where you can like at my Facebook and also subscribe to my channel, where the 31 videos has on date, and I keep on updating my channels, my videos over there. So thank you, and have a happy SAP consulting.
So in this copy, I have to give the material description, target material, and you have to follow these rules actually, PR00 rules. But now you are using which? Yes. So what you can do is, this particular line, so best option would be, see, in this type if you copy, the problem will be from, because your condition record is different, isn't it? Yeah. So it's better to go and create of your that means your own only, but open a PR00 and do that. Next time out from 8001 you can copy. You first open a PR00 on one screen, then create it. Yeah, you have to open PR00 and then.
Customer material, right?
Yeah. If you can see, get back to my screen now. I'll just show you that option. Got it.
Okay.
Yes. So you have seen mine, right? You're in my screen. You can see this copy condition table from condition type. You can see this target condition type.
So this is on what screen are you? Like it's a VK13?
VK34. Yeah. So I have opted you know VK34 templates. Go to logistics, go to sales and distribution, create with template. That option you use, then it works. That means you can use one template to others, then automatically it creates.
Copy how the condition type doesn't help, no?
Yes, yes. Any condition type you can copy from a template.
No, but I basically save as a PR00 new one, so I have to do the condition records also.
That's what record only it is.
Okay.
This template is record template only. Just try that out. I'm mute for some time, 5 minutes. Yeah. Hello. Yeah, Anurag.
Hello. Yes.
You're done with it?
No, it's just trying.
Like this, if you entire SD, if you do 10 sessions like this, you can do anything. Else. Like intercompany. Yeah, it's all about troubleshooting only, right? So this is the process where you're learning troubleshoot. VK34, yeah, create with template, yes, that goes to VK34, then go for prices, material price, yeah, 1010, then material P-109, because you're using the same material. If it would have been a change, then it is different, yeah, enter. No, that's not required.
No, it's not required.
Enter.
Enter?
Yeah.
Okay.
tell me, Sharan. Tell me, Anurag. Anurag.
Yes.
You have copied it? No, no, not this one. Go back. Back.
One more.
Yeah, you're in the template screen.
Yes.
Execute. Yeah, program execute. Yes.
Create
template. Yes.
You should be copy with template, right? Or create with template.
Copy is not there. Create with template only. Click it.
Yes. Edit. Material price.
Yeah. Oh, you're not getting that
screen. Shouldn't I put
8001 here? No need. Not now. See, no. This is the. Now you click on execute. Click on execute. Now again click on execute. Yeah. But PR0 you have already selected. Why it is not coming? No, you have gone back to a screen. Close this. This is not the one. No, not on that. That execute. No, not program. Down. There is one more execute. If you can go to VK34 once, VK34. Prices. It is showing with reference actually. It's not showing with template. With your newer version in your. So let me change. There is some problem because it's an older version. You can see my screen. You can see this.
A vast virus database has been updated.
VK34. So I'll go into material price or condition records, create with template.
Yes.
Then I'm going to prices, material price. Here. No, in your case, it's not giving you the material, though you're entering the material. Click on copy as from PR00. You have to give your yes. So, have you given the material name? Because when in this list, I think you are missing the material name. When this screen comes. Have you given the material?
Yeah, 109, yes.
P-109?